This is our TeraTerm terminal emulator. You may have no access to Reflection or other commercial terminal emulation program, so you may have found TeraTerm in the utilities directory of our disk. TeraTerm is a very excellent terminal emulation program that comes from a group in Japan. It's freeware, so you're welcome to use it. And if you like it, of course, send your comments and praise back to the authors. To get the best experience from TeraTerm, let's take a look at some of the settings. Click on the Setup button, and let's start with Terminal. Normally, I select my Terminal ID to be the highest Terminal ID that's compatible or appropriate with the applications I'm going to run, in this case VT320. You may want to change the Terminal size. Making this larger than 24 will put more lines of text on the screen, but 24, strictly speaking, makes you most compatible. And again, clicking on Setup Window. Here you can change the name or title of the window that you see on the screen, and this may help with identification. Change your cursor type. Scroll buffer. I like a big scroll buffer, so let's make this be 3,000. That way, as text scrolls off the screen, I can scroll back and look at it, and so on. I may want to capture some text and put it in a log file or send it off in an email to OSI. You can also change the colors. A lot of people make a different set of colors for each server that they connect to and save the settings files. So for example, I might want to make my text green, and the background color I might want to make blue. So we could try that. When you're done making changes on this section here, click OK. Continuing, let's click on Setup and Font. The default font is Terminal, which is the original system font used in Windows 3.0 and earlier. You may want to change it to a more modern font like the Lucida Sans typewriter. This will make for a slightly larger text window and slightly more readable text. Continuing with Setup, you may want to visit Keyboard. And what we'll want to do is select the behavior of the backspace key. And so we're going to send the delete key when we press backspace. And continuing on here, if you're connecting by serial port, you want to visit this box to set the settings of your serial port. I'm connecting by LAN, so I'm going to cancel here and click on TCPIP. Here you can set in the name of your server and click Add, and that will add that to the list of servers known, and you can use that in the future. Click OK. And then here under Setup, there's General, and you want to make your default port connection either TCPIP or the appropriate COM port. And once you've done this, then you can click OK and save your settings. So I'm going to save my setup, and since I've been practicing with this, I've got Chuck's Bobcat, so I'll save it as that. I'll show you in a minute how you can use this to launch the TeraTerm with these settings in the future. Let's log into our VMS server for the first time using TeraTerm. Your system manager has probably given you a username and password. So let's see if we can get started here. TCPIP is our method of connection. Our host is Bobcat. We added that to our list of connections we know earlier. Now I'll click OK. And wow, the first thing I see here is that this font isn't very good. Let me get logged in and change this. So I'll log in using the username and password my system manager gave me. And now let's come back here to Setup and Font. And I'm going to choose a different font. This Lucida Sans typewriter is really too lightweight. So I'm going to pick the fixed system font. That's much better. Okie dokie. And of course I want to click on Setup here, Save Setup, Chuck's Bobcat INI, and that way it'll be there next time I'm here. We're logged into OpenVMS now. Let me take a minute to help you set up a shortcut so you can launch the TeraTerm program easily. So what I've done is I've created a shortcut on my desktop that launches TeraTerm. Let's take a look at its properties. The properties here, this is the path to the directory where the program lives. C colon program files, TeraTerm Pro, and so on. Your location may be slightly different. But one of the things I did then is at the end of the command line, I added the server name, Bobcat, and then slash F equals, and the name of the INI file where I saved my settings to. So it's F equals Bobcat INI. If you like, you can set your starting directory to be where the TeraTerm program is installed, or you could choose some other directory, perhaps where you like to keep logs and upload and download files. When you're done with these settings, you just click OK, and TeraTerm will launch then and automatically connect you to your server next time.